Hi there.
Howdy.
You're our mailman, right?
Yes, sir.
So you're the one who's been delivering tacos to us every day.
How you like?
Yeah, I love them. They're really, really great tacos. But I'll tell you,
Jake.
I'll tell you, Jake. The wife and I noticed that since the tacos started coming in the mail, doesn't so much come as often or at all. Jake, what I'm getting at is, where's our mail?
Yeah, you want to know about the mail. Here's the mail situation. I can't fit both the mail and the tacos in the bag. It's hard enough fitting the tacos. I'll level with you. These bags weren't designed for tacos.
That's kind of what I'm getting at, Jake.
Well, don't tell me you're having a problem with the tacos, Jake.
I love the tacos. Okay. They may be the best tacos I've ever had. It's just that, well, I think if I had to choose between the tacos and the mail, I'd have to choose the mail.
Okay, I'm going to take a breath here. I'm afraid you might be saying something you don't quite mean. What I'm hearing is, you don't want the tacos.
Great tacos today, Jake!
Jake, you have to bring the mail. If we want tacos, we can always go to Taco Shack.
You're not going to eat that crap, are you?
Jake, if I miss my mail, I don't pay my bills, and I could lose my house.
Oh, so your concern is the importance of getting your mail.
Yes.
Well, bills.
Yes.
Oh, you know, you're right. I'm sorry. I just don't have the same passion for delivering mail as I do for making and distributing tacos.
You know, I quit.
I don't know what I'm going to do.
Jake,
you could probably get a job selling tacos to customers on a voluntary basis.
Listen, I just died inside and I don't really feel like talking.
So is he going to start delivering our mail now?
I don't know, sweetheart. But I do know this. That was the longest conversation I've ever had. Goodbye, mailbox.
Bye-bye.